I'm Mike Davis.
And I'm Jesse.
And today we're going to teach you how to play Six Nimmts. I don't know how to pronounce that. Whatever. That Six Nimmt. It's a good game. You'll like it. Trust me.
It's German.
It's German. Oh, okay. Six Nimmt is a 2 to 10 player game for ages 10 and up. It plays in about 45 minutes. And it comes with the 104 cards you see here.
So the object of this game is to collect the least amount of points. And you collect points by getting these bull's heads. As you can see, on 104 and on 1, you have one bull head. If you go through the other ones, 88 has 5 bull heads on it, 75 has 2 bull heads on it, 55 has 7 bull heads on it, and then 50 has 3 bull heads on it. So these are what you're trying to avoid getting the most. Because it's a lot of bull.
When setting up a game of Six Nimmt, you're going to deal 10 cards out to each player and deal 4 cards face up in the center of the table. Then each player is going to select one card from their hand simultaneously and place it out in front of them. And on the count of 3, 1, 2, 3, all players will turn their cards over. Starting with the lowest card, in this case the number 34 card, you're going to start placing the cards to the right of the row of cards that you placed in the center at the beginning of the game. It needs to go to a card that's lower than the card, but closest to us. So for example, this number 34 would go next to the 8 up top there. It's higher than the 8 and not higher than anything else. It's actually lower than the 36 down below there. The next highest card is the 55. And the 55 is going to go after the 36 because it's higher than the 36 and that's the closest card to it in value. The next card is the 60. And it's going to go after the 58, because the 58 is the closest one to it, and it's higher than 58. And then the last one is the 104. The 104 would go after the 72 down at the bottom there.
So eventually you're going to see that you're going to start to build up these rows. So if somebody takes and puts a 64 here, next to the 63, and then the next person comes along and wants to play this 65, they're going to have to play it at the end of the row where 64 is. But that now causes them to have a Six Nimmt. So you might be wondering why somebody would want to play the 65 right after somebody plays the 64. Well, what happened was I didn't know that that 64 was going to come out. I was hoping that I would be okay with my 65, but unfortunately I am not. Now that I've had to put this 65 here and it's the sixth card, I will now have to take these 5 cards in this row and the 65 will now become the first card as a new row. Now I'm going to take these cards and I'm going to put them off to the side in what's called my bullpen.
Another scenario you'll see happen in the game is someone will play a card that's lower than everything out there. For example, if I play this 1, you'll see that it is lower than all the other cards here. When that happens, I'll be able to select the row that I want to take. Well, in this case here, of course, the 104 and 72 down here is only going to give me 2 points. The 65 over here would give me 2 points also. So I may choose which row to take based on what cards I saw my opponents play in the same round. But in this case here, let's say I want to take these. These would go in my hand, off to my bullpen actually, and be my points now. And this would start the new row. Now any other cards that were played this round will be using that 1 just like a normal row. The game is over once you've played all the cards from your hand out to the table. When all the players are out of cards, you add up your score, and whoever has the lowest score wins the game. Thanks for watching, guys. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, how about give us a like and maybe subscribe. If you have an idea for a video for us to do in the future, we'd love to hear it in the comments below. Thanks for watching.